गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, मिनरल्स एंड एनर्जी रिसोर्सेस। सो दिस चैप्टर इज कमिंग इन ईच एंड एवरी एनसीईआरटी स्टैंडर्ड्स। फ्रॉम 6th स्टैंडर्ड टू 10th स्टैंडर्ड वी आर सीइंग दिस चैप्टर। सो लेट अस वंस अगेन गो थ्रू दिस चैप्टर, लेट अस सी व्हाट्स न्यू गिवन इन दिस चैप्टर। सो फ्रेंड्स, व्हेन वी से मिनरल्स, व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय मिनरल्स? सो मिनरल्स are nothing but combination of few elements, one or two elements, like you have iron, you have copper, two, three elements come in a certain quantity, and the composition of these elements we call them as a minerals. So depending upon the percentage of minerals which is higher in the composition, we call that particular region as a deposit of that particular mineral. So for example, particular region has a iron, does not mean it just have iron, it might have manganese, it might have limestone, it might have cobalt, but content of iron is higher, that's why we call that region as a iron ore or iron mine. So mineral is nothing but that what we have discussed. The technical definition given in this chapter of mineral is nothing but a homogeneous naturally occurring substance with definite internal structure. So yes, homogeneously occurring. So when we say a particular mineral is, area is a particular mineral, that means homogeneous. In that area, you'll see a larger deposits of these minerals. Okay. And it has a definite internal structure. So the arrangement of the different elements, their structure, their grain size is a particular. So they have definite internal structure. So for example, coal is a type of mineral. Then diamond is a type of mineral. Both are made up of carbon, but the internal structure is different. That's why the value is different, look is different, color is different, taste is different, everything is different. So this is called as internal structure. So mineral has a definite internal structure. So when minerals are formed, they take millions and billions of years of time for the formation. They don't form suddenly. So mineral is an outcome of a geological structure of that area. That means what types of rocks are there, whether sedimentary, whether igneous, whether metamorphic, depending upon the other elements, like what are the, if that particular area is surrounded by the tectonic regions, it is surrounded by the volcanoes, or it is a stable area but it has a river flowing nearby, or it has a very high wind activity. So depending upon the various processes of various agents, endogenetic processes and exogenetic processes that we have seen, so that also play a very important role in the mineral formation. And third most important is time. So nothing in this world can be devoid of time. So time is a must come factor in the mineral formation. In everything in this world is a result of certain amount of time. So as I have told you, minerals are nothing but a combination of various elements. So in this way, 2000 combinations have been found. We call them as a minerals. Now friends, let us understand certain interesting facts. Let us understand some classification as well. When we say minerals, in first chapter of resources, we have seen how we can classify them. So we can classify them metallic, non-metallic, energy minerals. These are the three ways of classification. Metallic can further be classified as a ferrous, non-ferrous. Ferrous means that which contains iron. So ferrous, non-ferrous, huge amount of minerals contain iron. Non-ferrous means non-iron containing mineral like bauxite, manganese, copper, lead that you have. Non-metallic mineral means what? Except metal, like you have limestone, you have sandstone. These are the metallic mineral. Non-metallic mineral, you have coal, you have natural gas, you have oil. These are the non-metallic minerals. They are also energy minerals. So oil, coal, natural gas, they are also energy minerals. So friends, in this NCRT, interesting fact about toothpaste is mentioned. So it's very interesting. I found question can be asked in your preliminary examination. So it's very important to know about this. So toothpaste contain various types of minerals. So for example, if you the white color in the toothpaste, or you can see over here, or specifically remember Colgate. So white color over here is given because of the titanium oxide. Getting it. So this toothpaste, it will be looking very very white and it will make your teeth white. Getting it. So this titanium oxide, okay, is giving this white color, which itself is a combination of 2-3 other minerals. Getting it. So you have to combine limestone, limonite, you have to combine anatase, you have to combine rutile to form this titanium oxide. Also, we have lots of tartars form on our teeth. So in the morning, we have to remove those impurities from the teeth. So you require something abrasive kind of thing, or it's a rough kind of thing you require. So this roughness comes from the silica, limestone, and some other phosphates. Getting it. So they are also there in the toothpaste. Also, you have seen the advertisements of various actresses, whether they will use the toothpaste which will have a sparkling kind of things inside. Okay. So this sparkles, like for example, Close Up. So these are nothing but a mica particles. So this mica is one of the very important minerals used in the toothpaste. Specifically, you want to make toothpaste attractive to the children. Getting it. So toothpaste is very very important, and these things are made up of various minerals. So when we are saying minerals, let us classify minerals and let us see the classification. Let us see the examples of all these minerals: metallic, non-metallic, energy minerals. So first, before seeing that, let us understand they are also classified based upon modes of their formation. Means what kind of rocks they are formed, how they are formed. So for example, mode of occurrence is the first way we can classify the minerals. So some minerals are found in the igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks. So you can see over here, this is one mineral, this is another mineral over here. So metamorphic rocks, igneous rocks, they develop cracks. They have certain lines. Getting it. So here they have veins. So here minerals get accumulated. Okay. So there will be joints, there will be faults, there will be cracks. So here minerals will be gathered. So if you have a smaller lines of these minerals, they are called as a veins. If they occur in a very smaller quantity. If they occur in a very larger quantity in a particular rock, it is called as a lodes. So lodes and veins. Veins, you know, in our body also we have small veins. So remember that smaller amount of minerals are there in the faults, joints of this metamorphic and sedimentary rock. You are calling them as a veins. And if larger quantity is there, you will call them as a lodes. So there are so many types of minerals. Like you have iron, you have copper, you have lead, and so many types of minerals which are formed in the metamorphic and the igneous rocks. Next type of minerals which are found are in the sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rock, we have already seen that because of the sedimentation from the rivers, these sedimentary rocks have formed. They have formed by the process of deposition for the millions of years. And because of this deposition, certain chemicals are secreted from the rock which make them compact. So in this way, these are the different layers of the sedimentary rock you can see. Okay. So here different minerals are get accumulated. Like we have coal, we have natural gas, we have oil, we have limestone. Getting it. So these are the certain minerals. Okay, they are formed in the sedimentary rock. Coal is also a result of heat and pressure. Sometimes it is also classified as a metamorphic rock. Getting it. Okay. And there are certain minerals, like you have gypsum, potassium, and sodium salts. So they are formed because of the evaporation, because of the very high heat and evaporation. What is happening? Because of this high heat and evaporation, capillary effect and drying up of water, these minerals are coming near surface. So in this way, minerals are formed in the sedimentary rocks in the form of beds and layers. Getting it? Now, let us understand the third type of, third area where minerals are formed. Third way the minerals are formed is because of the weathering of rock. So what happens? Rock gets decomposed. When rock gets decomposed, subtle minerals are there. They get accumulated. Rest of the, let us say, non-valuable part or lesser important part in the mineral or lesser minerals, they get weathered away. And a huge quantity of one mineral is being formed. So for example, bauxite. So for example, in this rock, bauxite, iron and manganese, three are present. Bauxite is of higher quantity. So because of the wearing and tearing of this rock, these manganese and iron gets withered away and the quantity of bauxite increases. This is also called as enrichment. So enrichment, withering gives the enrichment, decomposition gives the enrichment to the mineral formation. So in this way, minerals are formed in a different ways. Now, let us see fourth type of mineral formation. This fourth type is the minerals are found in the rivers, river bed themselves, in the sand dunes, in the desert they are found. They are called as a placer deposit. Okay. So generally, a huge amount of deposits of a particular rocks are brought by the river. So impurities get washed away and the particular density, because of the particular density of that mineral, those deposits will remain together and they will be deposited somewhere. So they are called as a placer deposits. So generally gold, silver, tin, this very highly valuable mineral, their placer deposits are formed. For example, take example name of the river Subarnarekha. Subarnarekha means streak of gold. In this river, from ancient time, placer deposits of gold have been formed. That's why this river itself has been named as a Subarnarekha. Getting it? So they are formed in the form of soil, in the form of sand. Getting it? So these are called as a placer deposits. So now, these are the ways how minerals are formed. Now in this slide, you can see how some people mine the minerals. So recently, this rat hole mining was in the discussion in Meghalaya. One accident happened. Because of that, few rat hole miners died in the mine itself. So this question about rat hole mining can be asked. So this person, you can see, he is digging very small hole. This is called as a rat hole. So what happens? Generally, minerals belong to government. But in the northeastern state, some villages, some families own the small areas of the minerals. They don't have technology to dig. They have coal and all these things. So what they will do? They will just mine these areas as the size of the human being who can crawl inside. So it is called as a rat hole. They will take out one bag, two bags, three bags per day and they will sell them in the market. This is called as a rat hole mining. This rat hole may go up to few kilometers somewhere. Getting it? Or few, let us say 500, 600 meter, they can go. So what happened in Meghalaya last year? Because of the rain, these people who were mining inside, they did not come to know that outside there is raining. And suddenly because of the cloudburst, what happened? Huge rainfall. These rat holes got flooded. So because of that, so many people died in the Meghalaya. So these people will mine this all the minerals which are present in the northeast and they will sell it. Now the NGT has ordered that this is illegal activity as all the natural resources belong to the people and in terms government of India. Okay. So friends, this is how these minerals are classified and this is one of the ways of rat hole mining. Now let us understand the types of the mineral and their distribution. If we see the distribution, it is very, very uneven. Very unevenly distributed. Some minerals are very high in the Deccan Plateau. Some minerals are very high in the eastern western ghats. Some are very high in the Himalayas. Some areas like alluvial plain, they are devoid of minerals. Coastal region, you have oil, natural gas, these types of minerals. So Deccan Plateau, you have a basaltic rock, you have metamorphic rock. So this is full of iron, this is full of copper, this is full of ferrous type of minerals. Eastern and western ghats are also, they are full of minerals like ferrous and non-ferrous minerals. Coastal region, as I have told you, is basically famous for the oil and natural gas. Alluvial plains, they have some placer deposits like I have told you Subarnarekha, but they are not in use that much. So plains have lost their importance in terms of minerals. Getting it? So most of the valuable minerals are found in the plateau regions of the India and western ghats and eastern ghats. Some non-metallic minerals, they are found in the Himalayas mostly. So for example, you will find the rock salt, you will find the shilajit, you will find other types of minerals. So some rivers are also famous for producing salt, like Luni River in the Rajasthan, it produces the salt. So distribution of the minerals are uneven all over the India. So friends, let us understand these types of these minerals. First is a ferrous mineral. Ferrous means iron containing minerals. Iron containing content might be more or less, does not matter. So because of the huge availability of iron, all the overall ferrous minerals, they are 3/4 of the overall value of production in India. So 3/4 of the minerals are iron containing minerals. So because of very high iron availability in the India, it is very good for the industries, because most of the equipments, most of the heavy machines, most of the industrial structure, most of the construction structure, iron is the most important thing. So it is a base industry. It is one of the 8 core industries in India. Okay. We also export huge amount of iron to Japan, Australia, Middle Eastern countries. Okay. So these are the ferrous minerals. So first one is the iron. So iron ore, very, very important. We can see yellowish and reddish color of these iron ore. There are 4 types of iron ores. You have magnetite, hematite, siderite, okay, limonite. These are the 4 types of iron ore. But here we are going to discuss only 2. Magnetite, a very high grade iron ore. It contains almost 70% of the iron. And hematite, it is 50 to 60% of the iron. So this magnetite, as it suggested, it is a high quality magnet. Quality wise, these ores are very, very high quality. So they can be also used for the production of the magnet as well as iron ore. So for metallurgical industry, these magnetites are very, very important. Quantity wise, if you see, quantity which is used and quantity which is produced, if you see hematite our availability of hematite is more in case of India. But the iron content in the hematite is little less. So we know various usage of iron, making of steel, and each and every aspect of our life, iron is used. Next mineral. So, okay, here let's understand the various belts of this iron. So first is the Odisha. So Odisha region, you'll find this Badampura mine in the Odisha. They are very, very important. Then near Jharkhand, over here, Singhum region also is famous for the iron. Then here you can see in the Chhattisgarh, Korba region or Bastar region, Chandrapur and Bastar region. Chandrapur belongs to Maharashtra, Bastar belongs to Chhattisgarh, you know, very highly infested by the Maoists. So mineral availability is very, very much high. That's why what is happening? Government of India is using that forest for the mining of the minerals, and it is resulting into the displacement of the tribals. So because of that, Maoism, Naxalism or Maoism has spread much in the Chhattisgarh area. Chhattisgarh is like a capital of Naxalites. Previously it was West Bengal, now it is Chhattisgarh. So Durg and Bastar region, very important region, is one of the iron producing region. Then you have Sindhudurg in Maharashtra, is also one of the iron producing region. Then you have Andhra Karnataka part, which is also one of the important iron producing regions. So these are the iron producing belt. So Goa, parts of Goa also we produce the iron. So Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kudre mukhs are very famous. Kudre means horse and mukh means face. So it looks like face of the horse. So Kudre mukh, one of the highest peaks of the Western Ghat in India. It is very famous for the very high quality of the iron ore. So these hematite iron ores are there, and because of this very high quality, it is exported. Getting it. So generally it is not exported by the train. They mix water in that and they have created a huge pipeline. So the slurry is made and it is coming to the Mangalore port. And through them, then they are exporting to the Japan, they are exporting to Middle East. Getting it. Similarly, we have Maharashtra, we have Sindhudurg region, which is very famous for the iron ore. Next is a manganese, again ferrous mineral. It is required for the production of steel. So manganese requirement is very high in production of the steel. So you see 10 kg of manganese is required. Also limestone is also required, and metallurgic coal is also required. Getting it. So manganese is used for that. Manganese have other uses as you have to make pesticides, you have to make bleaching powder, so, and the paints and all, so you require manganese in that production as well. So in this way, these two important ferrous minerals are there in case of India. Okay, now let us see the non-ferrous minerals. Let us talk about copper and bauxite, zinc, gold, all about them. So non-ferrous minerals, as we have seen, we have 3/4 production in terms of value. Okay, it's there. But non-ferrous mineral, we are not doing well in non-ferrous minerals. We are very deficient in the non-ferrous minerals. We are importing some of these non-ferrous minerals. So they are very, very important in engineering industry. They are very important in electronics industry, IT industry. They are very, very important. First one is a copper. Copper mines are found mostly in the MP and Rajasthan. Copper, as we know, is a non-replaceable metal for the electronic industry, electrical industry. Specifically, the wire which conducts the electricity, the copper is irreplaceable, or it is irreplaceable part of this industry. So copper, if you see, we are copper deficient country. Since ancient time we are using copper. So currently right now we have discovered that we can use them in the electrical industry. But since ancient time we are using copper utensils for storing water and some other purposes. So because in India we are using for the household purposes as well as electrical industry. So because of that, we are very copper deficient country. So Madhya Pradesh, Balaghat region and Rajasthan Khetri mines are very important. Also, Singhbhum in Jharkhand is also very famous copper producing states. Next mineral, it's very, very important mineral, is a bauxite. Bauxite is utilized for the production of aluminium. So right now what is happening? Steel is being replaced, or iron is being replaced by the aluminium. Why? Because iron is very heavy. Aluminium is strength wise as equal to as that of iron, but it is lighter. It is more malleable. So for example, aeroplane. You want to fly aeroplane in the air, but if you use the iron, it will be very heavy. It will catch rust. So in the aeroplane, same strength, aluminium will be used. So slowly, vehicles, two-wheeler, four-wheeler, aeroplanes, railways, instead of iron, we are using the aluminium. So, strength-wise, it is as strong as that of iron. It is more malleable than the iron. Its conductivity is also very, very good. Okay. So, that's why bauxite is one of the most important element for the production of the aluminium. Bauxite production, the leading state is Odisha. Getting it? So, Odisha is the leading state for the bauxite production. Koraput is, we can say, capital of bauxite production. Bauxite production requires lots of water. It requires lots of electricity. So, generally, bauxite plants are situated near dams. Getting it? So, we have Balco, one of the bauxite producing company. So, these are so many companies which produce bauxite. Okay, Balco and Nalco, so many companies are there. Okay, so Nalco means National Aluminium Company. So here, this bauxite production is there in, bauxite deposits are there in the Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and highest deposits are there in the Odisha. Okay, so you can see Katni is there, and Maikal Hills, Bilaspur, Amarkantak Plateau, they are very high in the bauxite, and also this Panchampalli deposits in the Koraput of Odisha, as I have told you, are important location for the bauxite production. There is very important and funny story about bauxite. This is Napoleon III, the successor of a great Napoleon. So what happened at the time of Napoleon III, recently the aluminium was discovered. It was very shiny and very white. It used to shine a lot. So what this Napoleon III has done, he replaced his buttons of his shirt with the aluminium. Previously, these kings used to make buttons with the gold and silver. He thought in future aluminium is going to be very costly, and right now that time it was very costly. So he replaced gold and silver with the aluminium. He wear all the metallic things on his body made up of aluminium. Also, to the guest, he served food in the aluminium plates. So those are very highly important guests. He served them in the aluminium plates. Those who were less important guests, what he said, he served them in the gold and silver plates. But later it was found that aluminium is a huge quantity, and beggars in the Paris, they started utilizing the aluminium. This is one of the important funny story. Okay, it is also given in your NCERT. So you can use this story in your essays. Anywhere you can use it. Now it's your talent where you want to use it. So friends, in this way you have to use each and every part of your NCERT in somewhere and others. Don't ignore the things saying that this is less important or more important. Now let us understand non-metallic minerals. Non-metallic minerals are like, we have coal, we have natural gas, we have oil, we have salts. So let us understand them one by one. First important mineral is a mica. Mica is found in the Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand region. Here you can see mica is present in the form of sheets, or it is also called as a leaves or sheets. Okay, mica has a property that it is a dielectric in nature. Dielectric means what? It does not collapse under high temperature and high voltage. So it is used as an insulator in the electronic industry. So sometimes if suddenly high voltage power comes to absorb that high voltage or shock, this mica is used. Getting it? So you can see it can be black, green, red, so many colors are there of that mica depending upon the surrounding climate. Okay, so it is one of the very important, and you cannot replace this in the electronic industry. So Bihar and Jharkhand region, Chota Nagpur Plateau, it is present in the sufficient quantity. Kodarma is one of the very famous regions for the mica production. And some other regions also it is present, like in Andhra, in Nellore it is present. Parts of Rajasthan also it is present. So mica is one of the very important. Next important minerals are rock minerals. So rock minerals means what? Rock minerals means they are found in the form of rocks. You directly use them as a rocks. Like I have told you, rock salt. They will sell you a huge piece of rock as a rock salt. You go to the home, make it a powder and put it in your food. So rock salt. Okay. Another important is a limestone. Limestone, calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate we are using. Okay. So generally sedimentary rocks, it is found in the sedimentary rock. So limestone is very important for the production of the iron and steel. So friends, these are some of the minerals. Now let us understand what are the hazards of the mining. So as we have seen these different minerals present in the different layers of the rock. So that lead to the various hazards of the mining in the surrounding area. This we have seen in the previous NCERTs as well. So you have open roof mining. So mineral dusts are flying in the air. Fumes of the minerals, sometimes minerals like coal, they are burning sometime under the ground. So when you mine them, the huge volume of this fume, they escape into the atmosphere and they're very, very poisonous. So dust, gas, it's one of the hazard of the minerals. Then again, as we have spoken about rat hole mining, so roof of the mines can collapse. There are some very famous novels like 33 Gallons of Water. If you read this novel, is about one of the roof of one of the mine get collapsed and water fills and some almost 40-50 people get stuck inside the mine. So many people die, but these people manage to save these people who are deep underground the mine. So there are these types of losses. Suddenly mines are filled with the water, suddenly their roofs is collapsing, all the people inside die. Getting it? So there are fires in the coal mine, as I have said you, in Jharkhand or Chotanagpur plateau. The coal is continuously burning because of certain internal heat as well as by activities of the people. This coal caught fire few decades back and it is continuously burning. So what happens sometimes in the Jharkhand, suddenly the house is there, suddenly fire will start coming from some part of your house. So this is because of this coal. Getting it? What happens sometimes, mines become empty and government authorities start dumping. They make it a dumping ground. So huge amount of garbage is thrown in that mine and this mine get filled with the water and that dirty water gets seeped into the groundwater aquifers. So what they do? They pollute the mines. Getting it? So these are the certain hazards of the mines. So health hazards are there, environmental hazards are there, forest is being destroyed. Then occupational hazards are there. People working in the mine, they are dying. Getting it? So these are the important hazards of the mining industry. Getting it? So these hazards, once they happen, they are spontaneous. Getting it? They will not be undo again in a less period of time. Okay. Now friends, let us understand about conservation of minerals. Why conservation of minerals is important? As we have seen, there is a hazard of mineral. So mining leads to the hazard. So if you don't conserve the mineral, you'll have to mine new minerals again and again. So if you conserve the mineral, recycle them, reuse them, find substitute of them, then all the hazards can be reduced. Getting it? So conservation of minerals can be done in this way. Okay, you can reuse them, you can recycle them, you can find the substitute of these minerals. For example, iron. Previous time, all the vehicles used to be made up of iron. Now they are made up of plastics. So we have find the better substitute, less mining of iron. Now we are using coal, natural oil, gas, but we have also found the solar energy, nuclear energy. So we are finding the substitute. We are recycling the iron. We are having improved technology. So we can mine minerals in a less hazardous way. So in this way, we can conserve the mineral in planned and sustainable manner. So there is a need of conservation of mineral to avoid environmental hazards, to avoid occupational hazards, to avoid social hazards, getting it. So this is the important thing mentioned in this chapter. Now let us move towards energy resources. These were about metallic minerals. Now let us move towards energy resources and energy minerals. Energy resources, also first chapter we have seen conventional energy resources like coal, natural oil, fossil, all the fossil fuels, and you have wood. Non-conventional energy resources, then you have a solar energy, you have a wind energy, we have a tidal energy, geothermal energy. These are the non-conventional resources. So let us see first the conventional resources. First one is a coal. So coal is very important mineral resources. Almost 60%, 70% of our power comes from the coal. So in India, coal occurs in the two forms. One is a Gondwana coal, another is a tertiary coal. So Gondwana and tertiary coals are very, very important. Gondwana coals are the best quality coals, very high value coals. They are found in the Deccan Plateau region. Tertiary coals are little bit less quality coal. They are found in the Northeast India. So how coal is formed? In this image, you can see this. Coal is a result of pressure, heat, time, depth. These four factors are there. So how deeply it is formed will determine the type of coal. The more it is found near the surface, lowest is the quality. Deeper it is found, higher is the quality. More the time frame, better is the quality. Quality in terms of heat content in the coal, we call it as a calorific value. So the best quality coal, that is Gondwana coal, is there. Okay. So you can see over here in this diagram, lowest quality coal is a peat. It has a very low calorific value. Then after that you have lignite. After that you have a bituminous. And the best quality coal is anthracite. It is not mentioned over here, but anthracite is the best quality coal. In this way, in different stages coal is formed. So anthracite coal found in the deeper region. It has more carbon content, more heat content. Pressure, heat and time which has been applied is more in case of anthracite and lowest in case of peat. So there are different regions. Like peat you will find in the Gujarat, Rajasthan. Lignite you will find in the Tamil Nadu, specifically Neyveli Lignite Company. You have heard about Neyveli region of Tamil Nadu. Also Gujarat and Rajasthan also you will find the peat and lignite. Getting it. Bituminous coal you will find in the Jharkhand region, Chota Nagpur Plateau, Andhra Pradesh, Singareni Mines, Chhattisgarh region. Here you will find this bituminous coal. And anthracite coal is present in a very low amount in India. It is present in the Jammu Kashmir region, but we are not mining it because of the environmental reasons. So coal, as we know, it burns. So after the burning, huge amount of residues remain. So that's why we call it as a coal, as a wet losing material. So whatever industries you have to set near the coal plant, because transportation cost will be higher. In the end, coal is going to lose the weight. So that's why coal thermal plants, power plants, and many metallurgical industries are situated near coal areas. Getting it? So this is one of the important thing. Next is a petroleum. So when the plants, animals get buried on the land, coal is formed. When fishes, plants, animals, they get buried under the ocean, petroleum is formed. So petroleums are present generally in the areas of where ancient time ocean was there or currently ocean is there. So for example, Bombay High, currently ocean is present. Barmer, Jaisalmer, ancient time ocean was present. Assam, ancient time ocean was present. So there you will find this petroleum. Petroleum is also one of the core industries. Depending on the petroleum, you have so many other industries. So that's why you are calling it as a nodal industry as well. Petroleum and natural gas, they found together. So we have Assam, we have regions of Mumbai High, we have Barmer, Jaisalmer. Ankleshwar is also one of the very important region in the Gujarat. So these are the different regions of the coal in the India. Next is a natural gas. Natural gas, more cleaner, more heat content than coal and oil. So very useful, very clean. That's why we are using compressed natural gas in the vehicles. In Delhi, some cities like Delhi, now the vehicles are banned using this government vehicles. They are using natural gas only. They are not using coal. Sorry, they are not using oil. Okay. So natural gas is very, very important. Transportation is easy. Transportation of coal is very difficult, very polluting. Second number comes oil, and the easiest way of transportation is natural gas. So we know Tapi, Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, India pipeline is, project is going on. Also in India, we have Hazira, Wazipur and Jagdishpur pipeline, which connects Mumbai High with the western and northern regions of the India. So this natural gas is used for various purposes. Industrial purpose, it is used as raw material for the fertilizer like urea production. Then it is used for the by the household as well. Getting it? So used in the vehicles as well. So natural gas has so many usages. So these are the important non-mineral resources, non-metal resources, non-metal minerals which are found in India. So based on this, let us understand the chapter called as electricity. So electricity is generated using these non-metal minerals, coal, oil, natural gas, as well as water. So depending upon that, we are dividing the electricity produced in the produced by the hydraulics or produced by the thermal. So you guys know about this. I don't think so there is need to repeat this again and again. Okay, so this is all about these conventional energy resources. Then there are non-conventional energy resources. So first one, we have a solar energy, wind energy, but we are not going to see this because it's very simple. We have already seen this solar energy. We have seen this. It is, we are one of the tropical countries, so huge amount of sunlight is available. So Gujarat, Rajasthan, entire South India is a very good region for producing the solar energy. Wind energy, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, they are ahead in the producing of wind, production of wind energy. Again, biogas. Biogas generally produced from the raw or raw organic material like farm waste, animal waste, kitchen waste can be producing the biogas. Biogas means nothing but a methane. So huge amount of biogas capacity is also there in India. The waste product of biogas, that is slurry, can be given to the farms. Okay. Then we have tidal energy produced because of the tides. So incoming tides in the bays, using their energy content in the tide, we can produce the tidal energy. So Gulf of Khambat and Sundarban Delta, we are producing this tidal energy. Geothermal energy. Geothermal means what? Because of the volcanic activity down, there are certain areas of, we can call them as a hotspot for the geothermal energy, which are very closer to the surface. So you can use certain equipments and capture that heat and using that turn heat in use heat to turn water into the water vapor, rotate the turbines and produce the electricity. So in India we have Parvati Valley near Himachal Pradesh and Puga Valley in the Ladakh, where this nuclear energy is being produced. So friends, these are the important energy resources. So conservation of energy resources is also one of the very important challenge in front of us. We have seen that why conservation of energy resources are important. So energy resources like coal, natural oil, gas, they are exhaustible, they are non-renewable. So in future, after 100 years, we won't have these resources. So that's why conservation is very important. So we need to shift from non-renewable to renewable energy resources. So that's why we are moving towards the solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy. We are also discovering nuclear energy, fusion reaction, fission. From fission to fusion we are moving. We are using the right now we are buying the uranium, but now we are seeing thorium as one of the viable alternative for India's energy production. So thorium is found in a sand called as a monazite. Monazite sands are found on the beaches of Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. So we are one of the first, Australia and India, they are the top two producers of this monazite sand. So future of Indian electricity is in the thorium. Getting it? So these are the various energy productions. Definitely we are going to see them again and again. Okay. Now based on this, let us find out the MCQs. Let us see the MCQs. Which one of the following minerals is formed by the decomposition of rock, leaving the residual mass of weathered material? So because of weathering, coal, no. Bauxite, yes. Gold, no. Zinc, no. Koder mine, the Jharkhand, is leading producer of which of the following? Yes, we have seen this. What is it? Minerals are deposited and accumulated in the stratas. Which of the following rock? Stratas. Sedimentary rock. Which of the following mineral is contained in the monazite sand? Just I have told you, thorium. So these are the answers to the question. So if you have any doubts, please ask me on the Telegram. Thank you.